الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على النبي الكريم محمد بن عبد الله وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. عن أنس بن مالك رضي الله عنه قال: جاء عربي إلى النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم فقال: يا رسول الله علمني خيرا. A Bedouin came to Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم and he asked Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم to teach him something good. فقال صلى الله عليه وسلم: قل سبحان الله والحمد لله لا إله إلا الله والله أكبر. So he guided him to say سبحان الله والحمد لله ولا إله إلا الله الله أكبر. How many of these? Four. فعقد أربعا ثم ولى. مضى تفكر ثم رجع. So on his fingers he went سبحان الله. His hand is there. سبحان الله كنت على يسر. الحمد لله لا إله إلا الله الله أكبر. That's four. And he took off, reflected, turned around and came back to Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم. فتبسم النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم ثم قال: تفكر البائس. Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم, when he saw him coming back, he smiled and he said, poor man, he thought about it. This is revelation from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم. So he came and he said, Ya Rasulullah, Subhanallah, walhamdulillah, la ilaha illallah, Allahu Akbar. هذه لله فماذا لي. He came, he wants something good for himself. And the Prophet ﷺ taught him something good for himself, but in the hereafter. He wanted something good for himself, so he left. You know how sometimes you ask someone a question, he gives you the answer, and you go, oh, thank you, and you turn around and you think, he didn't really answer me. And he came back with it. So he thought about it this way. He came and he told him, this is for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. What do I get? Now we know that there is hasanat, but we also desire something in this life. فَقَالَ لَهُ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمُ إِذَا قُلْتَ سُبْحَانَ اللَّهُ قَالَ اللَّهُ تَعَالَى صَدَقْتَ وَإِذَا قُلْتَ الْحَمْدُ لِلَّهِ قال الله تعالى صدق وإذا قلت الله أكبر قال الله سبحانه وتعالى صدق وإذا قلت لا إله إلا الله قال الله سبحانه وتعالى صدق وإذا قلت اللهم اغفر لي قال قد فعلت وإذا قلت وارحمني قال قد فعلت وإذا قلت اللهم ارزقني قال قد فعلت. So Prophet Muhammad told him, yeah, you're right. When you say subhanAllah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells him you're telling the truth. When you say alhamdulillah, you're telling the truth. When you say la ilaha illallah, you're telling the truth. When you say Allahu Akbar, you're telling the truth. And when you say, oh Allah, forgive me, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, you got it. And when you say, have mercy on me, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells you, you got it. And when you say, oh Allah, provide for me, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, you got it. So here the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam added three things for him. To do those, subhanallah, alhamdulillah, la ilaha illallah, Allahu Akbar, hayy al-baqiyat al-salihah. This is the best thing that you would have in the hereafter. And then he told him, and then ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to forgive you and to have mercy on you and to provide for you. All of this will benefit you here in this life too. فعقد على يديه سبعا. ليش سبعا؟
3 and 4.
أحسن. The first time, سبحان الله الحمد لله لا إله إلا الله الله أكبر. 4. اللهم اغفر لي، اللهم ارحمني، اللهم ارزقني. 3. ثم ولى. And then he took off. So what's the message for you, young man?
Tasbih all the time.
Made those tasbih. That is a special answer for a question that he came for. Bedouins don't normally ask too many questions and don't normally come to Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So this is a special trip, and the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam knows how valuable that is, so he gave him the best of the best. So to say subhanallah, alhamdulillah, la ilaha illallah, allahu akbar, you're praising Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with the best. And when you ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to forgive you and to have mercy on you and to provide for you, what else do you want? So stick to that inshallah, make that dua, and inshallah you will be happy in this life and the hereafter. Jazakumullahu khayr. سبحانك